You feel that you're on the right track. You do everything it takes. You move towards your goals, but then something is blocking you. In this video, I'm going to cover the topic of limiting beliefs and show you a three-step process to overcome them. First of all, I'd like to share with you a personal story about one of my experiences with limiting beliefs. When I was younger, I used to be very shy. Whenever the focus was on me, I wanted to run away, and I didn't like talking to new people. A few years ago, I had this idea to start a YouTube channel. I really wanted to create my own content and share it with the world. However, for 3 years it had been just a dream. I wanted it for 3 whole years, but did nothing. I didn't even start. Now when I look back and think about the reasons that stopped me from doing it, I realize that I had this limiting belief that I'm shy. And because I'm a shy person, it would be a disaster if I upload public videos to YouTube. What if people I know see it? I can't allow that to happen. But actually, even if they do see my videos, what could potentially happen? What is the worst scenario? Well, they might not like it. They might think it's stupid, or ridiculous, or useless, or not professional, and maybe even laugh. But is it really worth the price of not doing what I want, because of other people's opinion? So finally, after 3 years, I started the channel. But not this one. It was actually a comedy channel. A few months later, I decided not to continue with this channel and do something I'm more passionate about. So I started a personal development channel, which you're watching right now, Freedom Kingdom. Because my videos are animated, it was easier to allow this exposure. I don't really show myself. But what about the voice? I didn't want people to hear my voice and my English that is not perfect, or maybe they won't understand my weird accent. So I paid a voiceover actor and he did the voiceover for the first few videos on my channel. Later on it became too expensive and I also wanted this channel to be more authentic. I wanted you guys to hear me talking and tell you my messages and insights directly. So I gathered some courage and started to do the voiceovers myself. They weren't great at first, and even not now, but I can see that I'm constantly improving. I'm definitely less shy than I used to be, but when I stop resonating with this belief, I go beyond my limits. I accomplish another thing. Recently I uploaded some videos with my own footage, and even started my own vlogging channel. So can I still say that I'm shy? I keep surprising myself and get out of my comfort zone. People prevent themselves from achieving great things because of these beliefs. It's a self-fulfilling prophecy. You believe that you can't do something, or that things go in a certain way, and then you end up not doing what you want. You block yourself and let the limiting beliefs stop you from taking actions. If you believe that you're a failure and you will never be good at something, you eventually make it come true. How can you expect to succeed if you hold on to the belief that you're a failure? How can you improve if you believe that you'll never be good at it? People resonate with their beliefs too much and forget that these beliefs are only stories that someone once told us, and now we tell ourselves. A belief is a subjective statement about the truth. We all have belief system. It's a part of the human behavior. We gain most of our beliefs in the childhood, and they remain existing deep inside when we grow up. This is why if you're born to a religious family, you're more likely to believe in the religion. And it also explains cultural differences. What you're used to do and think in your country might seem outrageous or maybe even too conservative for people who grew up in other countries with different cultures. Our beliefs sometimes change according to the current fashion, the people that we hang out with, and if we change environment. When we are going to take an action, our brain checks if what we are about to do fits our beliefs, and then he decides to allow or avoid it. This process happens almost subconsciously, but that's exactly when you step in and take control of your decisions. Now I'll share with you a 3-step process to get rid of your limiting beliefs. This process is really easy and you can do it anytime. Step 1. Identifying the limiting belief. There are 2 ways to go through this step. The first way is to take your time and think about the things you want to do. Things you wanted to start but you keep procrastinate, and ask yourself what are the beliefs that you have about this subject. What is stopping you from starting? Listen to your answer carefully, because it's going to sound very convincing. However, if you think about it more deeply, you will realize that it's not the objective truth, it's just a belief. The second way is to catch yourself in your daily life. The small actions that you don't take because your limiting beliefs pop to your mind and block you. As I said, One of my beliefs that has stopped me from starting a YouTube channel was the belief that I'm shy. Is it true that I'm shy? Well, I remember myself as a shy person, but I also had moments when I wasn't shy, so it's not the only truth. Step 2. Is this belief serving me or harming me? Ask yourself this question. Every belief could harm us in a certain way. Even the belief that people are good can hurt us when we see people do bad things. Well, we can't get rid of all of our beliefs completely, this is our nature, but if we don't hold on so tight to our beliefs and we are open to look at situations from a different perspective, we can overcome anything that doesn't serve us. In my case, the belief that I'm shy didn't serve me at all, it just made me stay in my comfort zone and prevented me from growing. Step 3. I am not this belief. We have many thoughts, many beliefs and many emotions, but they are not us. They come and go, they change. Realize how much you resonate with your beliefs and decide to stop being dependent on them. I know that I used to be very shy, I'm still shy sometimes, but I proved myself wrong so many times. I started a YouTube channel, pushed my limits also outside of YouTube, and I keep overcoming my fears time after time. So just know that even if a belief was true in some cases, you can do the opposite in other cases. You've never signed a contract with this belief that you have to stick to it. So, step 1. Identifying the limiting belief. Step 2. Is this belief serving me or harming me? Step 3. I am not this belief. Now the next step you should take is subscribing to this channel because more content is coming soon. Thank you for watching. Write a comment down below and tell me about your experiences with limiting beliefs. See you next time!